Hello everyone. So today we are going to discuss about the
I'll speak anyways, repeating what I'm saying.
Don't interrupt, please. We want to pack before coming to Netherlands. Okay.
Oh no.
Okay. Calm down. I am going. Can you please vanish from here? Please go off. So let's continue the things that you need to pack before coming to Netherlands. Try to have a pressure cooker. That is a must in utensils because it will help you to save time. It will cook very fast. And try to have a couple of plates, bowl, a spoon, and some glass, and maybe a cooking pan and something to stir fry it. And check the IKEA video and also their website. They have all different types of utensils, home decor and everything you can buy from IKEA immediately after you arrive here. You will find almost every city in Netherlands has IKEA, so it won't be a problem. And you can have some basic food items, as I'm from India, so I'm speaking in terms of that, like rice, dal or lentils, basic spices like cumin, coriander, turmeric. And don't have too much because it will compromise your weight. You have a weight limit of 23 or 32 kilos of one or two bags depending on the flight you take. So try to have few spices for like 4 days or 1 week, and you will find everything, like every raw material, in Indian, Asian or Turkish shops. I've made video about Asian supermarkets, 3 or 4 videos. So try to have that, and it will be almost double the price. For example, a spice in India is like 60 rupees, then it will be 120 or 150 rupees, which is equivalent to 2 euros. So still, I would say it is better to buy them here instead of bringing too much food items, which are not that much price difference if you buy them raw materials and cook yourself. So always make sure that you cook yourself. I mentioned a lot about the cost of living video because it will save you a lot of money. So also try to have some pretty basic stationaries like sellotape, AA or AAA batteries. Batteries are really, really expensive here. So try to bring some batteries. It will be useful if you are using batteries in different appliances. Few AA, few AAA batteries will be enough. Try to have a bunch of pen, like 20 Usenthro pens, and maybe a marker. What else? Maybe a nail cutter, small rope, and some clips to clip cloths while drying them. And try to have a soap. If you don't like soap and use body wash, then better buy it here in the supermarkets. Don't bring it with you. And try to have some deodorants, toothbrush, toothpaste, this kind of basic things. And one important thing is the trimmer. Trimmer is a very handy tool that will help you to save a lot of money. I've also mentioned about this in the cost of living video because I always cut my hair myself. I think it looks pretty good, right? No. Okay, just the thing is that don't forget to buy the trimmer. It will be around 40 euros with 5-year warranty from Philips, pretty decent quality, and which is approximately around 3000 rupees in India. It will help you in both hair and beard and everything, body hair, everything. So what it helps you is, like, it will save a lot of money because you don't go out to cut your hair every 2-3 months and spend 10-15 euros, which is really, really expensive compared to one-time investment of 40 euros. Have some cash, like 500 to 1000 euro, I would say 1000 euro, and try to have denominations of 20, 50 and 10 euros also. Initially, they will be useful. Don't carry only 100 euros. And although you can get change, but for first term, have like at least 2 notes of 20, 10, 50 euros. And don't forget one thing I forgot. Don't forget to bring a decent universal travel adapter, like from Indian to European or Indian to rest of the world. Just like this, a universal travel adapter. This works in every different countries. It has 3 different for Europe, US, UK, everything. So here, most of the things, like everything, is 2-pin. So in India, you have like 3-pin. So you need try to carry 2 or 3 or 4 universal adapters depending on the devices you have. And for the phones, like the mobile chargers, if you have a thin 2-pin charger, then they will fit here also. My phone charger fits here. And everything else, which has two pin, mostly fits here. You don't need a converter for that, like adapter. And apart from the cash, try to have a Forex card or a travel card. I bought the SBI travel card. The advantage in the SBI travel card is that they can be topped up from India by anyone. And I would guess any travel card, most of the travel card, depending on your host country, can be topped up from there. Then it will be really useful because everything here is digital. They accept digital currency. It's very popular. They don't need to, you don't need to have cash with you. So what you can do is, like, if you do this kind of transactions in supermarkets or anywhere you pay with using that card, then you don't pay any extra cost if you have a travel card. But if you try to withdraw money from the ATM, then you need to pay around 2.5 or 3 euros per transaction. So in that sense, I would say travel card is much, much more convenient when you want to have the continuous supply of money in case of emergency. Because depending on your situation, sometimes people who arrive here via the university, it takes like 1 month or 20 days for the amount that they have sent for the first year in the blocked account to be transferred to their own bank account. So in that case, some cash and the travel card will help you a lot. And even your bank account and bank card will take some time to arrive. So keeping that in mind, a travel card will always be useful, even if you travel inside or outside Netherlands. What else? So try to have the important thing, have some attention, the clothing. So clothing is like one of the most asked questions, and I would say don't bring too much winter clothes. Have a light jacket, although it shows you now in summer it's around 15 degrees. I would say, like, in Netherlands it's like last few weeks ago it was 30 degrees, but now it has dropped to 15. The weather changes very fast. It's very sudden change of weather. Once you come here, you'll get used to it, and it rains a lot, although now it is not raining. So try to have a light jacket which also works in the rain and the wind. And it's also very windy because there's a huge coastline and it's very near to the coast, so it is windy. So in that sense, try to have a light jacket, and you can buy everything from here. You'll find superior quality of winter clothes in Hema, C&A, Primark, or just check my video about Primark and C&A. So you'll find everything there. Like, they're really good quality and they're really, really cheap. Around 20 to 25 euros, it will help you in wind, rain, winter, with a heavy jacket, not a light jacket. That everything is covered in that. So for you, I would say just have a light jacket for the first week, and once you get to know these shops, then everything is fine. So I would say try to have a pair of jeans, maybe like 3 or 4 pair of jeans, I would say. Yeah, like have 3 or 4 jeans. So because jeans are very expensive in my opinion as compared to Indian price. The jean prices starts from 40 euros or something like that. So it's better to have jeans. And also shoes are expensive if you want to buy branded shoes like Nike or Adidas. As I have seen, they are cheaper in India. So I would say, like, have something like 2 pair of shoes and 1 pair of formal shoes. And don't forget to bring a suit, like the coat, the one that you wear on the top, because mostly people wear informal, and sometimes in formal occasions they have a jean pant and wear a coat on top. So those are very expensive here and might not fit you. And then if you go to the tailor, then it will be very, very expensive, my friends. So try to have a suit with you. It will help you in some occasions. And what else? Don't bring any mattresses or blankets or anything. Those are very, very cheap. You'll find fleece blankets in 10-15 euros. And normally in furnished houses, you have everything. Blankets, utensil sets sometimes, and toiletries, utilities, bed, mattress, cupboards, furniture, everything. And if your house is unfurnished and you are not a student, normally who are not student, they have unfurnished house, you can buy pretty much everything from IKEA. Just have a glimpse of the video so that you can have an idea about IKEA, how it looks inside. I have made a video on it. And check the website, and once you come here, just immediately go to IKEA in the first week itself, or maybe in the first day if it is possible, because IKEA is having like everything, like furniture, home decor, washing machine, what I would say, like fridge. It has everything, basically everything. You'll find from A to Z what you need in your new home. And you can also, if you don't like fleece blankets, you can also have duvets, which cost you around 20-30 euros. And those are like pretty good cotton, and they don't, I mean, it depends if your skin is allergic to something like that. So what did I miss? Let me check my notes. I try to have like the documents in offline and online version. So have like save them in the cloud and have some backup copies offline in your laptop and phone, and also try to have like two or three hard copies. So in case any of them gets lost and you need to reproduce them immediately, then it will help you a lot. This is a very simplistic advice, but some people don't pay attention to it in the rush of packing. So try to, and also make sure to see the dimensions that you need to follow for the plane and the weight limit that you have in the plane. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, then don't forget to smash the thumbs up button and share this video with all your friends, because recently I got a lot of comments and I'm happy that people like the videos, and this motivates me. Subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to subscribe. And in the upcoming videos, I'll tell you about housing and the part-time jobs. That is also a much demanded topic, but I didn't get much time. So I hope that you will share with all your friends and put your comments below. I know I have not covered everything. I cannot cover everything. So whatever I missed, put them in the comments. I will try to reply to them, or I will try to make a separate video depending on the amount of questions I get. Okay, don't forget to check the text of this, whatever I have said. I put it in a blog in my official academic website, sambitprayaraj.com, in the description below. So I'll share it. There you can read it, and you can also check Quora, where I have given structure to all the things that I'm saying now, all the 120 videos that I've made till now, and I'll be making more videos about studying and living in Netherlands. Also check our Facebook group, where we help all of you, because we have an international team and we're slowly growing. So we have people from Germany, Netherlands, and I think from Switzerland, who guide and coach people who have different types of questions about jobs, studying, immigration, residency, and other type of things. Thank you everyone for 1k subscribers, and I hope we march forward very fast and we run towards the 10k subscribers by the end of this year. So follow me on Instagram and Twitter. Check my Twitter link in the side link, and also my Instagram. Peace off.